today's topic is beta and gamma functions. Using gamma function, we have to evaluate integral 0 to pi by 2 sine power 5 theta into cos power 7 by 2 theta into d theta. So for that, so we have to use a certain formula here using beta and gamma functions. So here is the formula: using integral 0 to pi by 2 sine power 2m minus 1 theta into cos power 2n minus 1 theta into d theta is equal to half times of beta of mn. So we have to use this formula in order to solve this one integral. So in place of 2m minus 1, so we have 5 here, so I am equating 2m minus 1 as 5, and in place of 2n minus 1 we have 7 by 2. 2n minus 1 is equal to 7 by 2. So we have to abstract the values of m as well as n and substitute in this formula. So 2m is nothing but 5 plus 1, and m is equal to, this is a 6 by 2, and m value is nothing but 3. And if you see here, n is equal to, this is 1 plus 7 by 2, and 2n value is nothing but, this is 9 by 2, and n is equal to, this is 9 by 4. So as we got the values of m as well as n, and we have to substitute here. So what is the question here? The question is nothing but integral 0 to pi by 2. This is a sine power 5 theta. This is a sine power 5 theta into cos power. This is a 7 by 2 theta into d theta is equal to. Now we have to substitute in this formula. That is half beta of m comma n. So what is our m value? So I am substituting here. So this is m is equal to 3 and n is equal to 9 by 4. And we have another important relation between beta and gamma functions, as beta of mn is equal to, see here, this is gamma m into gamma n by this is gamma of m plus n. Now I'm going to substitute in this formula. If I use this, this will be gamma 3 into this is gamma 9, 9 by 4 by gamma of 3 plus 9 by 4. And see what happens here. This is, and again there is an important property here. Gamma n is nothing but n minus 1 factorial. So this can be written as, this is 3 minus 1 factorial into gamma of 9 by 4 by, so if I take an LCM, this is 12 plus 9. So which is equal to 21. So this is 21 by 4. And again I am going to use another property. That is, gamma n can be written as n minus 1 gamma of n minus 1. So using this property, I'll apply here. So this will be half times of, so 3 minus 1, which is equal to 2 factorial, and this is gamma 9 by 4. And if I apply in this formula, this will be n is 21 by 4. This is n minus 1 gamma of, this is n minus 1. And see here, I can easily cancel this one, and what remains in the numerator? Gamma of 9 by 4 by, so if I take LCM, this will be 21 minus 4 by 4, and here also 21 minus 4 by 4, and see, and our next value will be, so here if you see here, so this will be gamma of 9 by 4 divided by, so 21 minus 4, it is nothing but 17 by 4 into gamma of, this is also again 17 by 4. Again, if I apply the formula as gamma n is equal to n minus 1 gamma of n minus 1. So if I apply here, then this will be gamma of 9 by 4 by, so this will be 17 by 4, n, what is n here, 17 by 4 minus 1 gamma of 17 by 4 minus 1. See here, I use this property, that is n minus 1 gamma of n minus 1. See, then this will be gamma of 9 by 4 divided by, this is 17 by 4 into 17 minus 4, which is equal to 13 by 4 into gamma of 13 by 4. Again, if I apply the same formula here, this is 9 by 4 and this is 17 by 4 into 13 by 4 into, this is n minus 1. So this is n minus 1 gamma of, this is n minus 1, and see what happens here. This is gamma of 9 by 4 times of, this is 17 by 4 into 13 by 4. If I subtract 4 from 13, this will be 9 by 4, and this is also gamma of 9 by 4. Now I can easily cancel these two and see what remains here. So this will be 17 into 13 into 9 by 4 into 4 into 4. So 4 into 4 into 4, which is equal to 64. And if I multiply all these, that is 17 into 13 into 9, the value here is 64 by this one is 1989. Therefore, our integral value, that is integral 0 to pi by 2 sine power 5 theta into cos power 7 by 2 theta into d theta value is nothing but 64 by 1989. So this is how we have to solve. So simple. So we have to compare with our formula here, and again we have to calculate the values of m and n. We have to substitute here, and we have to use this important relation between beta and gamma functions. So I have transformed in terms of gamma, and so these are the two properties which I have used to get a solution here. So the final answer here is so simple, that it is a 64 by 1989. Thank you so much for watching and staying till the end. If you really like this video, you know what to do. Please practice. Definitely you can do by your own.